The history of popular social movements in Iran dates back at least to the tobacco protests of 1890s. The tobacco protest was an anti-colonial movement against the tobacco concession granted by the Shah to Great Britain, and it succeeded in forcing the government to retreat from its policy. The Constitutional Revolution of early 1900s was the first democratic movement in Asia and led to the establishment of Iran's first parliament in 1906. Popular uprisings and mass mobilizations continued with the movement to nationalize the Anglo-Iranian Oil Company under the leadership of Prime Minister Mohammad Mossadegh in the early 1950s. In 1953, however, Mossadegh's democratically elected government was overthrown in a coup d'etat conducted by the CIA and with support from the British government. After the coup, Mohammad Reza Shah returned to Iran and remained the all-powerful monarch until the uprisings of 1970s, which led to the Islamic Revolution of 1979. For a brief period after the revolution, Iranians witnessed the opening up of social and political life. Shortly after the revolution, the Islamic Republic began to forcefully and systematically silence dissent, eliminate opponents, and limit social and political freedoms. During the 1980s, many were imprisoned, tortured, and executed. In particular, starting in July of 1988, for a period of 5 months, the Iranian government executed thousands of political prisoners. According to Abrahamian, these killings were an act of violence unprecedented in Iranian history, unprecedented in form, content, and intensity. Through the 1990s, dissent and resistance found new expressions in intellectual productions, films, music, and challenging of social and political norms at the public and the grassroots level. In 1997, 80% of eligible voters voted in the seventh presidential election since the 1979 revolution, and 70% of them voted for the reformist candidate Mohammad Khatami. Women and student voters played a significant role in the election of Khatami, which came to be known as a historical moment in Iran's reform movement. In the late 1990s, Iranians once again experienced a brief period of relative political openness. On July 9, 1999, after a peaceful demonstration by a group of students at Tehran University, a group of paramilitaries entered a university dormitory, attacking students. At least one student was killed and about 300 were wounded. For the next 4 days, demonstrations and even violent protests took place in Tehran and other major cities. On May 20th, 2009, the Guardian Council announces the names of four approved candidates out of a list of 450 registered prospective candidates. The approved candidates include Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, the incumbent president, Mohsen Rezai, commander of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard from 1981 to 1997 and current secretary of the Expediency Council, Mehdi Karoubi, Speaker of the Iranian Parliament from 1989 to 1992 and from 2000 to 2004, and Mir Hossein Mousavi, Prime Minister from 1981 to 1989. In the first week of June, televised presidential debates are held on Iranian national TV. The debates stir up controversy following accusations made by President Ahmadinejad regarding former presidents Mohammad Khatami and Akbar Hashemi Rafsanjani. During the debates, other candidates criticized Ahmadinejad's record and accused him of mismanagement and of falsifying information and statistics. Between 40 to 50 million people, or 60 to 70% of the population, watch the televised debates every night. The debates bring a great deal of enthusiasm and excitement to the election campaigns. On June 12th, Iran holds its 10th presidential election since the 1978 revolution. Mousavi warns about election fraud, telling the press that his campaign's election monitors have not been allowed near voting areas, and that mobile booths and SMS have been illegally shut down. Voter turnout is high, with over 80% of the electorate casting their vote. At the closing of election polls, both Ahmadinejad and Mousavi claim victory. Iran's official news agency announces that with two-thirds of the vote counted, incumbent Ahmadinejad has won the election with 66% of the vote. One day after the results are announced, Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei gives his blessing to the outcome of the election. Ahmadinejad gives his victory speech with tens of thousands of flag-waving supporters gathered in Tehran's Vali Asr Square. Mousavi, Karoubi, and Rezai challenge the results and launch formal appeals. Mousavi and Karoubi supporters take to the streets. On June 15th, despite government's warnings against holding rallies, 3 million people in Tehran marched towards Azadi Square in protest to the official results. Many hold signs that read, "Ra'y man kojast?" Where is my vote? Many protesters, as well as a large number of political activists, are arrested in Tehran and other cities. On June 19th, in his sermon after the Friday prayers, Ayatollah Khamenei announces that he will not give in to illegal pressures to change the results, and that the opposition leaders would be responsible for bloodshed and chaos if they did not stop the demonstrations. The next day, thousands of protesters take to the streets of Tehran in open defiance of warnings issued by Ayatollah Khamenei. According to reports by state-run media, 10 people are killed, 100 injured, and close to 500 detained. Amateur videos are circulated through the internet showing scenes of killings, shooting, and beating of protesters involving the riot police, military, and paramilitary forces. With many opposition leaders and political activists in prison, under house arrest, or with limited access to public, the protests become increasingly sporadic and self-sustained. Nevertheless, responding to a call by Mousavi, thousands attend a peaceful prayer gathering at Quba Mosque, mourning those killed during the post-election clashes. A number of influential political figures, including many clerics, attend the gathering. A peaceful silent march is held after the prayer. Demonstrations continue in Tehran and other major cities through July. Protesters use occasions such as the anniversary of the 1999 students' protests, commemorations of those killed in previous demonstrations, and the Friday prayer to gather in large numbers. Police and paramilitary forces use unprecedented violence to suppress protesters, using batons, pepper spray, and firearms. By early to mid-August, reports come out indicating that 72 people have been killed and at least 4,000 arrested. Many are tortured, and according to a number of accounts, some of those arrested are sexually assaulted and raped. Media outlets are subject to severe censorship and in some cases shut down. In a series of show trials that are still underway, hundreds of prisoners are brought to court and forced to make confessions in the court and on government-run television. In an act of solidarity unseen since the years leading up to the 1979 revolution, Iranians and sympathizers organized protests in cities all over the world. Just as the anti-colonial movements of previous centuries left a lasting impact on social and political life in Iran, the post-election popular uprising revitalized the Iranian society and the hope of change.